Dear friends, I spent about 36 years of my monastic life in various capacities at Advaita Ashrama, both at Mayavati and Calcutta. Mayavati is nestled at the foothills of the Himalayas. This place is to me a Devabhumi, a Shangri-La, the earthly Eden of universal wisdom and ineffable peace. Even a faint smell of worldliness does not dare to penetrate these Himalayan heights. Rightly it has been said as Devatatma Himalaya, Himalayas ensouled in divinity. Prabhu Bharata has stepped into its 125th year, marking it the longest running monthly English magazine in India. Some of the greatest minds of India and the world have contributed articles to this. Over the years, Prabhu Bharata has inspired and shaped the thinking of many. At one time, Mahatma Gandhi used to eagerly wait for the journal. Dr. S. Radhakrishnan used to read every issue of this journal with great interest. Prabhu Bharata is yet in the initial stage of unfolding itself, for as long as mankind seeks truth, the journal will fulfill the purpose it is meant for. Because it derives its sustenance from the infinite world of consciousness, wherein is the source of all blessedness and peace. It is Swami Vivekananda's greatness that he started 3 periodicals even during his own lifetime: Brahmavadin and Prabhudvarta in English and Udbodhan in Bengali. It is difficult to ascertain exactly when Swamiji first conceived the idea of publishing journals, but we can assume that from the time he resolved to disseminate Sri Ramakrishna's life and message, he must have thought of establishing periodicals for the purpose. Even before going to the West, he had seen how religious movements were rising all over India and what an impetus journals and dailies gave to those movements. He also understood that the enthusiasm he received from the public would die down if the same was not channeled through an organization and a mouthpiece of its own. When Swamiji was at the height of his glory in America, he wrote to Alasinghe Perumal to start the journal for which he will send articles from time to time and the money to publish it. Alasinghe Perumal holds an important place in the annals of Ramakrishna movement. It was he who persuaded Swamiji to represent Hinduism in the Parliament of Religions and collected money for his going to America. The first magazine that was started was Brahmavadin in Chennai. When the Brahmavadin was only 10 months old, another journal called Prabhudvarta or The Awakened India was published. We should remember that Prabhudvarta was not a competitor of Brahmavadin. Swamiji wanted that Brahmavadin should be for scholars and elders, whereas the Prabhudvarta should be started for bringing the message of Vedanta to the general public. Mr. B.R. Rajam Iyer, The first editor of Prabodha Bharata was a graduate and a talented young man of 24. The success which the Prabodha Bharata achieved within 1 year was simply phenomenal. The extraordinary popularity of the magazine was due to the beautiful interpretation of Vedanta. However, the magazine had to be shifted to Almora and then to Mayawati after the untimely passing away of Mr. Rajan Iyer. A monastery can be started anywhere, be it in a cave or in a dense forest. But to start a publication department on the DG heights of the Himalayas was a daunting task. It was no mean achievement to keep the monthly magazine running for over 125 years in spite of the difficulties in conducting the publication work in the midst of the Himalayan jungles, situated at an altitude of 6,500 feet above sea level. It is staggering to imagine how monks worked faithfully even in stringent financial conditions. Cold, rain and snow, compounded with shortage of paper, ink, etc., and carrying materials on horsebacks from a long distance, and then dispatching the journal at the equally distant post offices. Mayawati became a home to Prabodha Bharata and Advaita Ashrama. The motto of the journal was kept, "Arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached," an Upanishadic dictum from Kathopanishad. This inspirational shloka was Swami Vivekananda's message to the world to get out of its hypnotized state of mind. The dictum was meant as a call to his countrymen to awaken their sleeping soul and propagate the message of peace and blessings to the world. On 24th April 1897, Vivekananda wrote a letter to Sarala Ghosha. In that letter, he stressed giving the public only positive education because of his belief that negative thoughts weaken men. In that letter, he also reiterated his strength giving words, "Arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached." Vivekananda quoted this shloka in several lectures and discourses. In a lecture delivered on 12 November 1896 at Lahore, he said, "Therefore, young men of Lahore, raise once more that mighty banner of Advaita, for on no other ground can you have that wonderful love until you see that the same Lord is present everywhere. Unfurl that banner of love, arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. Arise, arise once more, for nothing can be done without renunciation." According to Sister Christine, Vivekananda wanted to see men striving to find the Supreme. In her reminiscences, Sister Christine writes, "All else might be false, this alone was true. He realized it. After his own great realization, life held out one purpose, to give the message with which he was entrusted, to point out the path and to help others on the road to the same supreme goal. When I joined Advaita Ashrama, I was asked to read handset proofs of Prabodha Bharata For many years, the general printers used to print our magazine. They had linotype machine. It was a hot metal typesetting system to set type, especially small size body text for newspapers and magazines. The press provided proofs on rough newsprint paper. It was very difficult to read them. However, with the advent of computers, the typing of manuscripts and page makeup for Prabodhabharata came to be computerized from the September 1993 issue. The first issue we brought out was on the occasion of the centenary of Swami Vivekananda's participation in the Parliament of Religions. The printing was done in an offset press in Calcutta. In April 1996, a computer with laser printer was installed at Mayavati for composing and layout, but the printing was done in Calcutta. Later, we brought out special issues to mark special occasions like centenary of Prabodhabharata in 1995, centenary of Swami Vivekananda's return from the West in 1997, centenary of the founding of Ramakrishna Mission in 1997, centenary of Advaita Ashrama Mayavati in 1999. Besides this, other special issues were brought out from time to time. To celebrate the 150th birth anniversary of Sri Ramakrishna, we brought out one anthology from the old issues of Prabodhabharata entitled A Bridge to Eternity, and the subtitle was kept Sri Ramakrishna and His Monastic Order. Another anthology containing some of the outstanding articles published during the last 100 years was brought out in connection with the centenary of Prabodhabharata under the title Art, Culture and Spirituality in 1997. These precious articles would have been lost to the coming generations had they remained only in the back numbers of the journal. However, well bound and preserved. In the year 2010, we brought out a DVD which contains all the issues of Prabodhabharata from its inception till December 2009 in a digital format. I had the privilege to construct a spacious building which now houses the Prabodhabharata editorial office and a big library meant for it. It was inaugurated on 22nd October 2017. The biggest contribution of Prabodhabharata Press has made it the publication of the complete works of Swami Vivekananda, Authentic and Comprehensive Life of Vivekananda by His Eastern and Western Disciples, Swamiji's Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Lectures from Kolamo to Almora, and Bhagavad Gita with English translation by Swami Swarupananda. So all these books were brought out from Prabodhabharata Press. Through the pages of Prabodhabharata, the message of Sri Ramakrishna, Vivekananda and Vedanta has gone into the hearts of millions of people. In 1924, the life of Sri Ramakrishna by Swami Nikhilananda was published. It was followed by two important books on life of Sri Ramakrishna and Swami Vivekananda by Roma Rola. Many scriptural texts like Vivek Chudami, Aparokshana Bhuti, Uddhava Gita, Ashtavakra Samhita were translated by our monks and then serialized in the Prabuddha Bharata. Later, these treatises were brought out in book form and are available till date. Similarly, Brahma Sutras, according to Shankara and Ramanuja by Swami Vireshwaranji Maharaj, were also serialized in this important organ of the mission and later published in book form. When I was manager of Advaita Ashram, I remember one day one Italian gentleman came and placed order for 700 copies each of the Brahma Sutras by Shankaracharya and Ramanujacharya. In those days, we used to sell 500 copies of each in a year. I was surprised, how come this man is purchasing 700 copies each of this difficult book? I frankly asked him whether he had read Bhagavad Gita and the Upanishads, because without sufficient knowledge of the Upanishads and the Gita, it is hard to understand Brahma Sutras. When he said no, then I asked him what he was going to do with these books. He said that these books were prescribed as textbooks in some American universities, and he has to supply these books to them. Likewise, some of the Upanishads published by us are being taught in different universities in India and elsewhere. These are considered as authentic and reliable. Swami Vivekananda wanted to make Advaita Ashrama the center for diffusing Vedanta teachings. This function, right from the inception, is being discharged through this magazine and other publications in an admirable manner. Many monks who worked at one time or the other in Advaita Ashrama Mayavati were sent abroad to take up the work of preaching Vedanta in the West. Special mention may be made of Swamis Ashokananda, Nikhilananda, Raghavananda, Madhavananda, Nishreshananda, Vandananda, Adishwarananda, Chetanananda, and many others. Swamiji appreciated the old age tradition of renunciation and pursuit of spiritual realization. Many rishis from time immemorial immersed themselves in the infinite and turned their backs on the finite. He saw that this needed correction. Our incarnations like Rama, Krishna, Shankaracharya, Chaitanya took upon the task of helping mankind to get enlightenment. Swamiji knew that India needed some of the practicality of the West and that the West needed the spirituality of the East. As a world teacher of both East and West, Swamiji knew that meditation and realization must be put to practical use for the relief of the sufferings of the world. When he attained Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Sri Ramakrishna said, "Now you know all, but this knowledge will be locked in a chest, and I will have the key. Not till you have done my work will you have it again." Prabuddha Bharata took up Swamiji's mission forward and introduced Advaita Vedanta. It published articles on the immortality of the soul and on the oneness of the soul with God. It preached the law of karma and reincarnation as applied to the apparent self, and the truth that religion and science are not really opposed to one another, but are actually seeking the same goal. Prabhupada Bharata is urging its readers not to be content with mere verbal theories about God, but to translate theories into practice and actually realize God in experience here and now. It stresses harmony of four yogas, harmony of different religions, and harmony of East and West. Through its articles, Prabhupada Bharata is asserting that all the stages of man's spiritual evolution as Dvaita, Vishishta Dvaita and Advaita are not mutually conflicting as was supposed to be in the past, but complementary to one another. All cults forming the core of world religions can be accommodated within this framework. It articulates Swamiji's dictum, his soul is potentially divine, and all the sadhanas of karma, bhakti, yoga and jnana are meant for its actualization. It stresses there is absolutely no need for fanatical quarrels or religion. They are all due to ignorance and must be treated as a disease. Hundreds of articles have appeared in the pages of Prabhupada Bharata on the harmony of religions. I wish very much this journal, started by Swamiji with a special purpose, inspires countless spiritual seekers in the years to come. In the end, I thank Swami Shuddhidanandaji, the Adhyaksha of Advaita Ashrama, for giving me a chance to share my sentiments with you all. Thank you.
Dear devotees, we are glad to inform you all that Prabuddha Bharat has entered the 125th year of its existence. You all know that Prabuddha Bharat is the English monthly journal of the Ramakrishna order. It is the journal which was started by Swami Vivekananda himself in 1896. Why did Swami Vivekananda start this journal? Swamiji started this journal in order to bring out the universal scientific spiritual wisdom hidden in the Vedas, and in order to make this spiritual wisdom popular not only in India but all over the world. And Swami Vivekananda very strongly believed that it is in and through this spreading of the spiritual wisdom that India can be awakened and the entire world can be awakened. And Prabuddha Bharat in the last 125 years has been silently doing this work in a commendable fashion. The spiritual articles published in Prabuddha Bharata has impacted the thinking class of people all over the world, and it has resulted in a silent awakening. But we have yet a very long way to go. We need to promote this journal. We need to get more subscribers. And in order to promote this journal, Advaita Ashrama has initiated this Prabuddha Bharat campaign, a program which is essentially meant for promoting this journal. Now, what is this Prabuddha Bharat campaign? In and through this Prabuddha Bharat campaign, all that you need to do is bring 5 new subscribers for Prabuddha Bharat. That will be an act of great contribution from your side, an act of great punya, a very meritorious act, in and through which you will be helping Prabuddha Bharat grow and also helping fulfilling Swami Vivekananda's vision of spreading the spiritual message all over the world and also in India. So we honestly appeal, every follower, every devotee, every admirer of Swami Vivekananda, to come forward and participate in this Prabuddha Bharat campaign and bring 5 new subscribers for the Prabuddha Bharata and help Prabuddha Bharat grow. Thank you.